Students, in the last class we discussed about the concepts of percentages, and now here in this class we are going to discuss different problems related to the percentages. Okay, see, actually the concept of percentages has some logics. Based on that logics we will generate some shortcut tricks, and then we are able to solve problems based on that logics. See, we are not allowed to discuss shortcuts in this class. Okay, we are going to discuss, see, how to solve the problems using the logics. There are only few logics which we discussed in the previous class, and there are totally 5 logics. Using those 5, we are going to solve 5 to 6 problems in this class. Among those, I mentioned you here 2 problems, 6 and 7. Okay, see, 5 points are completed with the previous class, and now 6 and 7. See, look at the 6th problem. See, the problem is about the price of petrol. The price of petrol is went up by 25%. Okay, in order that expenses on petrol should not increase, one must have to reduce. See, we need to reduce his travel by how much percent, and that's the question. Is it clear? See, what is the question? See, the price of petrol, the cost of petrol is increased by 25%. Okay, since the cost is increased, to maintain the same expenditure on the petrol, see, we need to reduce our travel. Okay, see, petrol cost perigindi, manam petrol meeda spend chese amount same ga undali ante manam em cheyali, manam kodiga tiragadam tagichukovali. Since petrol cost is raised by 25%, by what percentage we need to reduce our consumption? By what percentage we need to reduce our travel? Mana yanta percentage tiragadam tagichukovali anedi this particular question. Okay, see, you just look at the question once again. Yeah, see, the cost of the petrol, the consumption, see, how we will spend the amount on the petrol, what is the expenditure on the petrol, that you need to identify. What I am going to tell you is expenditure. Okay, expenditure on petrol is usually nothing but price of petrol into travel. Is it right? Price of petrol into travel. See, the number of kilometers we are traveling, as well as the price of petrol. The travel, in the sense, in my point of view, travel is nothing but consumption. Is it right? For example, the price of petrol is, if you say, 80 rupees per liter. Okay, and see, I will travel usually a distance of, you may say, some 40 kilometers. Okay, see, the price of petrol is 80 kilometers, and I will go by 40 kilometers per day. See, depending upon the capacity of the vehicle, we need to calculate the price as well as the consumption. But for example, what I am going to tell you is, if the price of the petrol is 80 rupees per liter, and usually I will consume, you may say, some 160 liters of petrol. Okay, see, 1 liter is 80 rupees, and if I consume 160 liters, or if you say 100 liters, what is the expenditure I need to spend? 1 liter is 80 rupees, I am consuming 100 liters, then the expenditure is 100 into 80, 80,000 rupees is the price of petrol. Is it right? Expenditure on the petrol. My expenditure on the petrol is 100 liters I need, and each liter costs some 80 rupees, if you say. So my expenditure is that consumption into this price of the petrol per liter. Okay, here, see, this price is raised by 25%. We need to analyze the question. See, this price is raised by 25%. And whereas, how much we need to reduce our consumption? That's the question actually. Okay, see, rising in the price usually represents what? Rising in the price automatically raises my expenditure, as well as, see, decrement of the consumption also affects our expenditure. And now our question is, for example, before rising the petrol, if my expenditure is some amount of this expenditure, this is my amount before rising the cost of petrol. If the petrol cost is raised by 25%, then what will be the new expenditure? Then the new expenditure is 125% of expenditure. That's what I am saying. This is just analyzation of question. Now what I am going to tell you is the way of solving the question. How to solve it? See, if you say this is the amount spending on the petrol by me, since the cost is increased by 25%, then the new amount to spend is 125% of the expenditure. But I am not interested to spend this new amount. I am interested to spend the same amount. Okay. So for that, I need to reduce my consumption. So to reduce my consumption, see, by how much percent we need to reduce our consumption, that's what we need to think. So this difference amount, we need to compare with the new price. This difference amount we need to compare with the new price, then only we will get that decreased the amount of the consumption. So what I am going to tell you is, you may say this expenditure is some E and the new expenditure is some 125% of E, and the difference between the old amount and the new amount is what? The difference between the old amount and the new amount is 25% of E. Is it right? This is the difference between these two amounts. Yeah. When you compare this difference amount, as we discussed maybe in third point or fourth point, when you compare this difference amount with expenditure, 25% we are rising. If you compare this difference amount, this new expenditure, see, if you compare it with this, what will happen? Comparing the difference with this value, 25% of the expenditure divided by 125% of the expenditure into 100, and that's what we need to calculate. Percentage of expenditure will get cancelled, okay? And if you cancel it, 25 5s is 125 and 100 by 5 is 20. So you need to reduce your consumption by 20%. Is it clear? Once again, I am telling you, okay? Just look there. The question is actually is about the expenditure on the petrol. The expenditure should be same. Is it right? So expenditure is usually price into consumption. Since the price is increased by 25%, we need to think about by how much percent I need to reduce my consumption. I need to reduce my travel to maintain the same expenditure on the petrol. So to maintain the same expenditure on the petrol, since the price is increased by 25%, see, the old price and the new price, okay, if I won't reduce my consumption, automatically, since the petrol price is increased, my expenditure also will increase. See, my old expenditure is some E and my new expenditure is 125% of E. But I am not interested to spend this much amount on the petrol. So, to get the same amount, I need to decrease this amount by some percentage. So, by how much percentage I need to decrease it? So, as an amount, I need to decrease this value. So, this value is how much percent of this new expenditure, that's what I need to find. So to find it, you need to compare this difference value with this new value and into 100. Okay. So I discussed you this, see this particular concept in some point. Okay. See the old value and the new value. The difference between those two values is the 25% of this E. So this 25% of E is a number, and that number is 25% of this old value, and that number is 20% of this new value. So if you rise the old value by 25%, you will get this new value. As well as if you decrease this new value by 20%, you will get the old value. And the question is asking you about how much percent we need to reduce this new value to get the old value. See, I need to reduce 20% by this new value to get the old value. And at the end, your answer for this question is what? 20%. This is a logical way to solve this particular question. Okay? See, if you need the traditional way, okay, not this logical way, you need to move with this particular formula. Expenditure is equals to price into consumption. Price is increased by 25% and consumption is to be reduced by some question mark percent. Okay? Can I discuss this also? Yeah, this is one way, very simple and smart way of solving this problem. If you are searching for the traditional way, see what I am going to tell you is, just look there, I will give you another solution. And before that, you just have a screenshot for this and then I will give you the next one, right? Have a screenshot for this. Yeah, now think about the traditional way of solving. See, usually what I am going to tell you is expenditure on the petrol should be same. Before and after. See, before, if you say my before the price is what? Some P. P is the price. And before the rise of the car petrol price, my consumption is some C. So price into consumption is the expenditure. Okay, this is the old expenditure. And what is the new expenditure? Petrol price is raised by 25%. So 125% of P is the new price of the petrol per liter. And into the new consumption. What is my new consumption? I need to reduce by question mark percent. So my new consumption is just nothing but 100 minus question mark percent of C. Okay, this is the old consumption. That consumption I need to reduce by some question mark percent. So this old expenditure is P into C, and this new expenditure is this 125% of P when multiplied with that 100 minus question mark percent of C. We need to solve it to get the value of question mark. See, just look there. P into C is equals to 125 divided by 100 of P, in the sense into P, into 100 minus question mark divided by 100 into C. Yeah, we need to solve it, okay? See, I think you all know the way of solving these type of equations, right? You just cancel out this P and C, okay? Or you send that like this. So then 25 5s and then 25 4s. And again, 5, 20s is 100. And see, look there, nothing is there in this numerator except this 100 minus question mark. And in the denominator is 80. So 80 is equals to 100 minus question mark, and that question mark value is equals to 20. You just look there, this is the traditional way of solving. And before that, I mentioned you the logical way of solving. Just go through this, okay? So in this way, you need to analyze all the questions to solve from percentages. Now, the seventh problem, just look at the board. See, due to reduction of 61/4% in the price of sugar. Just think about it. For the previous problem, the cost of petrol is increased by 25%, and this problem, the price of sugar is reduced by 61/4%.
Good.
Okay. And a man is able to buy 1 kg more for 120 rupees. And we need to find the original and reduced rate or price of the sugar. See, that's the problem actually. See, first of all, you just think about the question. You need to analyze the question first of all, okay? The price of the sugar is reduced by 61/4%, okay? Since the cost of sugar is somewhat lesser. So automatically, I will get more sugar for the same amount, okay? So usually, I will go to the shop to bring sugar with an amount of 120 rupees, if you say, according to the problem. If I move to the shop with an amount of 120 rupees, okay, I will get some cases of sugar before the change of the price, and after the change in the price, I will get 1 kg more when compared with the before quantity. Is it clear? My amount is same. I am going to the shop with an amount of 120 rupees before the decrement of the price or after the decrement of the price. And if I move to the shop with 120 rupees, I will get some cases, okay? Some quantity of the sugar. You may say it as some X cases, okay? And after the price decrement, if I move to the shop with the same amount, now this time I will get 1 kg more for the same amount, 120 rupees. That's the question. Is it clear? Yeah, I think so, everything is clear, okay? Now, I need to find out the original price of the sugar as well as the new reduced price of the sugar, okay? Old price and the new price of the sugar I need to find. Yeah, see, you need to think about one thing first. What is the difference between the old quantity and the new quantity? Okay, I will get some kgs before the decrement, and I will get 1 kg more after the decrement according to the question. So the price difference between the old and the new is 1 kg. Is it right? As per the question, it is 1 kg. Okay, the price difference. And now you need to think about the cost difference. Okay, I am moving to the shop with an amount of 120 rupees before and after. Right? So before and after I am moving with 120 rupees. Since the price is decreased by 61/4%. Since the price is decreased by what? 61/4%. Then for the same quantity, the difference of the amounts is 61/4% of 120. Is it clear? See, before the amount I am spending is 120.
After that also I am spending the amount as 120, but since the price is decreased, right? Since the price is decreased, actually no need to pay 120 rupees. It is enough to pay 6.14% less than for that 120. But I am paying total 120 so that I am getting 1 kg more. Is it clear? You need to analyze the question, okay? See, with that analyzation, it is very clear that the difference between the quantities is 1 kg. The difference between the amounts, old amount and the new amount, is 6.14% of 120. So, what I am going to give you is you need to compare. You need to think about the difference between quantities, and you need to think about difference between amounts. If you think about the difference between quantities and difference between amounts, difference between quantity is 1 kg and difference between the amounts is 6.14% of 120. That in the sense, cost of 1 kg, it is clearly suggests that cost of 1 kg is equals to 6.14%. If you rewrite it, for 6 is 24 and then 1, 25/4, percent means 1/100 of 120. That's what we need to solve. Okay? See, 25/4 into 120 in the sense 4 threes is actually, and 1 zero also get cancelled. Now if you say 25 threes is 75, 75 by 10 is 7.5. Yeah, 7.5. So the cost of 1 kg of sugar is 7.5 rupees. Why it happens? Because the price is reduced, so the cost is what? 7.5 rupees. So you need to say that, therefore, the reduced price of the sugar is what? 7.5. Is it clear? And you need to think about the original price again. Okay, just have a look at the problem. First of all, if you go for a screenshot, and then I will discuss the way to find the original price. Is it right? Right. Think about it. The cost of 1 kg is 7.5 rupees. That's the reduced price. And you need to think about the original price. See, I don't know the original price. So for that, you just let that original price. Yeah, original price. If you say the original price is equals to some X. Okay. And that original price is reduced by how much? 6.14%. Since X rupees is reduced by 6.14%, then we need to write it like this. X is reduced by 25/4%. Okay, 100. See, what I am going to tell you is 100 minus 25/4% of X is equals to 7.5. That's the reduced price. This X is the original price. That original price we need to reduce it by 25/4%. Since we are reducing X by 25/4%, as we discussed, 100 minus 25/4% of X is equals to 7.5, and I will write that 7.5 as 15/2, and we need to solve it to get the reduced original price. Okay, see how to solve it. You just think about it. Usual way of calculation: 100 minus 25/4. See what we say it as. 400 minus 25, 375. Okay, 375/4 into 1/100 of X is equals to 15/2. That's what we need to solve. You just think about it. Is there any way of calculation? Yeah, 15, 2 is 30, and 15, 5 is, okay, what I will tell you is 15, 2 is 30, and 15, 5 is 75, and 25, 4 is 100. This 4, 4 is 16, and on solvation you will get that X is equals to 8. Therefore, the original price of the sugar is 8 rupees. You just have a look at this. And once again, I am dealing with the question. Just look there. There is a change, difference between the original quantity and the new quantity. And there is a difference between the original price and the new price. See, the difference between the quantities is 1 kg. And the difference between the amounts is 6.14% of 120. So, you need to compare those two. So, the cost of 1 kg is this 6.14% of 120. If you calculate, you get it as 7.5. So, the cost of 1 kg is 7.5 rupees. This is the new price. But I need to find the old and the original price also. That original price is just nothing but you say it as X. Since the original price is X, that price you need to reduce by 6.14%. So since we are reducing, you need to take like 100 minus something. So 100 minus 25 by 4% of that x is 15 by 2. Okay, the original value minus 25 by 4% of the original value is the new value. And on calculation of this, you will get that x is equals to 8. At the end, the original value is 8 rupees, and after reducing, the new value is 7.5 rupees. Okay, that's the question. Just have a look. Usually, you will get different types of questions, different questions related to this particular concept. Okay, just have a look. Go for a screenshot. 8th problem, look there on the board. When the price was reduced by, not reduced, okay, increased, okay, when the price was increased by 24%, a family reduced their consumption in such a way that expenditure was only 8% more than before. If 31 Ks per month were consumed, then find new monthly consumption. Just think about the question first. The cost of the rice is increased by 24%, okay? Since the price of the rice was increased by 24%, if you maintain the same consumption in the sense, amount, the quantity of the rice what we are using, if that consumption is same, then our expenditure also will increase by that 24%. But a family just reduces their consumption to maintain that, the expenditure is just 8% more than the before. Is it clear? Actually, if they won't reduce their consumption, if they won't reduce their quantity of the rice, they have to spend 24% more expenditure when compared with the previous expenditure. But here, since what happens, they just reduced their consumption only to increase the expenditure by 8%, okay? That is the sense, they are not completely reducing, they are not completely increasing, they just reduced some quantity, they just reduced some amount of consumption, so that they need to raise their expenditure just by 8%. The cost is increased by 24%, but the consumption, the expenditure is just reduced by what? 8%. So in such a case, if they are consuming 31 Ks per month before, then what is the new monthly consumption? Then what quantity they are consuming now? That's what we need to identify. Just think about the question. As I mentioned you, in each and every case for these type of problems, expenditure is equals to price into consumption. Is it right? For example, if they are consuming some 31 kgs and see, 1 kg of rice, if it costs some 5 rupees, what is their expenditure? If you say, see, if the cost is some 5 rupees and they are consuming 31 kgs, then the expenditure is just nothing but 31 into 5, and which is 155. That's the expenditure, okay? So usually this is the very generalized formula which helps you to solve these type of problems. Expenditure is equals to price into consumption. Now I will give you the way how to solve it. Just you think about it. Yeah, old expenditure. You say it as old expenditure, and I am representing that old expenditure value by E, and that old expenditure is equals to how much? See, price into consumption. We don't have the price here. So okay, you just let the price as something. You may say it as some T rupees per case. Okay, you may say that T rupees per case or X rupees per case. So the price is T rupees and their consumption is 31. So at the end, what I have is the old expenditure E is equals to 31T. 31 is the quantity and T is the price there. And now new expenditure. See, what is the new expenditure? New expenditure is the new price into new consumption. Is it right? New expenditure is equals to new price into new consumption. Yeah. See, just have a look. Everything is very clear, okay? Old one is completed, and now we are thinking about the new expenditure, and that is new price into the new consumption. That new price is how much? This new price is given by 24% more. That in the sense, 124% of T is the new price, because old price is T, right? And we increased that price by 24%. So new price is 124% of T. and new consumption. That new monthly consumption we need to find. So this is question mark. That's what we need to find. And what you say about the new expenditure? See, they are reduced their consumption just by to maintain that expenditure was 8% more than before. See, the new expenditure as given, this is 8% more. So you need to write it like 108%. If it is 8% more, 100 plus 8% of E. If it is some 10% less, 100 minus 10% of E. Like that we need to write, okay? Yeah. So at the end, 108% of E is equals to 124% of T into question mark is the fundamental line to solve this particular problem. And in the next line, 108% of that E is actually what? 31T is equals to 124% of T into question mark. So you need to solve this to get the answer. Is it clear? Yeah. Now how to solve it? 108% of 31T. Just it is nothing but 108 divided by 100 into 31 into T is equals to this side, 124% of T. So 124 by 100 into T into question mark. That's what we need to calculate. See, if you compare both sides, what will happen? The calculation part is yours, okay, not mine, but I will solve for you. Okay, 100 and 100 will get cancelled. T and T also will get cancelled. I need question mark. So 108 divided by 124 into 31 is equals to question mark. And if you calculate it, okay, since I have no space, I am leaving for you. If you calculate, you will get that question mark value as 27. So their monthly new consumption is 27 kgs. Just think about it. The problem is completely based on the fundamental logic that expenditure is equals to price into consumption. Okay. So what is the old expenditure? Price into consumption. What is the new expenditure? New price into new consumption. That new price as given 124% of T, and that new expenditure as given 108% of this old expenditure. And on solving that, we are getting that question mark, which is the new consumption as 27. Okay, just have a look. Go for a screenshot.